Good evening, everyone. I've got some terrible news. I grew 3 foot over the weekend. Yeah. It's pretty bad. I've been taking these growth hormones, and I grew. Sorry about that. We don't have cameras tall enough to see my face. But many of you may be relieved about that. Wait, look. Hey, my hand looks quite magician-y, doesn't it? Do you know what this could be if you were, like, if you're watching this right now and you're high, you're welcome. But I... But right now I'm thinking... I'm just thinking like this. This could be like an instructional magic video. Like, tell the audience you have nothing in front of you. Show them your sleeves. Nice watch. And then, look, I've got a little bit of string tied around my wrist. And people say, Craig, why do you wear a little string tied around your wrist? Well, it's to remind me that I'm not in the Kabbalah.
Live around that.
Late Show. I am your host, TV Straight Ferguson. Please enough. Thank you. Please. Let the noise of your completely genuine applause die away quite naturally, like some sort of rippling pool. Still high from the weekend. You and me both. It is a great day for America, everybody. Terrible day on Wall Street, though. I thought Joan Rivers had just come in there. No, it was a terrible day in Wall Street. The stock market fell 1 gazillion points today. And Congress has botched this bailout deal. Experts on Wall Street say it's the biggest disaster to hit New York City since the Mets. I'm sorry, Mets, but come on! Everyone, of course, it's been a couple of days, but everyone's still talking about the debate. I thought it was great. It was exciting, it was informative, it was riveting. Yeah. I'm talking, of course, about the debate between Heather Locklear and the cop who pulled her over. It's terribly sad. You hear about this? That's terribly sad. Heather said, I haven't been this wasted since I slept with David Spade. Her and me both. Take that, internet rumor mill. No, I'd remember Spade. That's what they say. Once you'd never mind. What am I talking about? The debate between Barack Obama and John McCain. Of course. Wasn't it great? No. I'm sorry. It didn't really crackle for me. McCain looked sleepy. Obama looked stiff. No one threw any punches. I was like, well, come on. Be invested in this. Some people said it was like a heavyweight fight with a lot of clinching, you know. I think it was more like a breezy romantic comedy. See, this is the part where they're getting to know each other, they're ice skating in Central Park, they're bumping into each other, they kind of look up, they kind of, oh. They're saving all the tension for the next debate. That's where Obama gets on the plane, but McCain must run through the airport to stop the plane taking off on time or else they'll never get married.
You had me at
change. Speaking of change, I need another diaper.
Hey, don't hoo me. I'm just reporting the facts. They've sobered up, and now they're judging me. No one agrees who won this debate, of course. The Republicans say that McCain won, and the Democrats say that Obama won. Bill Clinton says that Hillary won. And the next debate is on Thursday night. It's the vice presidential debate, the VP debate. Now, where I come from, VP stands for visible panty line. There better not be visible panty lines on Thursday night. I'm talking to you, Biden. You know I'm talking to you. That's what I'm talking. Thank you. David Spade's in the audience. What the hell am I talking about? Oh, yeah, the debate, the VP debate. It should be a terrific debate. Joe Biden versus Sarah Palin. There hasn't been a matchup this exciting since Alien versus Predator. It's like Rosie versus Trump. Which was also known as Lesbian versus Predator, I think. Wow. Now, the VPs only get one debate, so it's really important. Now, I've heard people say the vice president doesn't do much in office, so it's not a big deal. I've got two words for people that say that. Dick and Cheney. Yeah. The last 8 years, George Bush has been a heartbeat away from the presidency. That's all I'm saying. What are you implying, Craig? What are you implying? Actually, I met George Bush. He's fabulous. He was very nice to me. Anyway, he let me come into the country, which I think is very pleasant. Didn't stop me being a citizen. I'm like, hats off to you, sir. Anyway, for this election, though, the VP choice is, of course, very serious because John McCain, look, let's be honest. He's older. He's an older gentleman and he's had health issues. It kind of makes Dick Cheney look like a picture of health, is what I'm saying. So it's interesting. Now, in this debate, Biden is known for putting his foot in his mouth quite a lot. I can do that too. But I don't use my foot. Why are you? I don't know, you people are filthy. Thank you, yoga. Anyway. Anyway, listen, last time Sarah Palin was questioned in an open forum like this, it was a long time ago. It was the Alaskan Beauty Contest 1984. The footage is on the internet. She's very quick on her feet, especially with the foreign policy. Look at this.
I believe that our education, like such as in South Africa and the Iraq, everywhere, like such as.
That wasn't really Sarah Palin. I'm sure she's a very good debater. You can't become the governor of Alaska with just twiddling your thumbs. You have to convince almost 300 people to vote for you. You can't just walk into that job. It's not just like shoot a moose, here's your governor's mansion. It's not like that. Anyway, I'm definitely watching the debate on Thursday. It's always interesting to see a man debate a woman. Because people have suggested that, you know, Joe Biden practice debating with Hillary Clinton. But I'm like, no, practice on a woman. Anyway, Joe Biden. No, I'm kidding. Anyway, Joe Biden. David Spade just make a joke here somewhere. Anyway, Joe Biden, he's got to be careful. You can't look too mean when you're debating, or he's going to look like a bully. And she can't be too forceful, or she'll look all kind of like a nag. Now, I'm all for feminism. I believe in feminism. Men and women should be treated equally, but that does not mean they're the same. What, Craig? We thought they were the same. No, they're not. Really? Yes. Yes, they are. Men and women are different. Okay, I'm expecting the blogs any minute. How dare you? Men and women are perceived differently in the public eye, you know. Do you know how I think Joe Biden could even it out for the debate? He could show up and drag. Do we have, by any chance, have a picture of Joe Biden and drag? Maybe. Jeez. That's... Looks a bit like David Spade, actually. Anyway, the debate on Thursday will be 90 minutes of passionate political discourse followed by 10 minutes of passionate makeup sex. That could happen. Sometimes when you're talking to someone on television, you get, you know, there gets sexual tension happens. It happens on this show quite a lot. Friday when Drew Carey was here, I was like, oh. All right, we have to take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. We'll be right back.
White Trash Style Tips with Tim Gunn.
White Trash.
On women, the mesh half shirt can be festive and breezy. But remember, ladies, this garment's provenance is athletic. It was originally intended for football teams during practice. So don't sport this look unless you're the type of girl who's not afraid of too many men on the field.
White Trash.
Thank you, Tim Gunn. He is never wrong. I'm very excited about the debate coming up. And now, listen, I am not a political expert, but I am going to, I will tell you who's going to win this bet on Thursday night. Win this bet? Yeah, it's a bet. The debate. The debate. I might bet on it, actually, because, come on. Who's going to win? I'll tell you, Sarah Palin. Why? Because a man cannot win an argument with a woman. Never. I know. Oh, Craig, is this the 1950s? For heaven's sake, we are past all of this now, aren't we? No, we're not. I speak from experience. I have argued with plenty of women and I have always lost. It does not end for me. Well, I consider myself a master debater until I... What? You argue with enough women, you will be a master debater. I tell you. That's all you'll be doing. Sometimes I think I reveal too much. What was I going to talk about? I was going to talk about the Prince Charles, wasn't I? A lot of people think that Prince Charles is just the Prince of Wales. He's not. He's also the king of late night television in the UK. Did you like how I did that? He's not. I haven't done that before. I'm going to be doing that more often. Anyway, let's take a look now at the clip from Prince Charles's BBC Late Night.
Live from Buckingham Palace, it's the Rather Late Programme with Prince Charles. Brought to you by the British Darts Association. Darts, the sport of choice for fat, drunk people. Ladies and gentlemen, the King of Late Night.
Welcome to the Rather Late Programme. I'm your host, TV's Prince Charles. Hey, listen to this. According to a new study, online social networking websites are now more popular than pornography. Clearly, they weren't studying me. Hey, you know, seriously, in America, everyone's still talking about the vice presidential nominee, Sarah Palin. I'm a lot like Sarah Palin. I'm gorgeous and ambitious, and no one wants me to take over if the old bitch dies. Do you get it? All right, let's just show... Oh. No. 5-second rule, they're still good. Let's ascend to the throne, shall we?
Do we have time for a parchment?
Of course.
It's time for a parchment.
Hey. All right. Hey, this is from Paul at Buckingham Palace. Oh, Paul's Buckingham Palace? What does it say? Dear Prince Charles, I am the palace guard who stands next to you on your show. I'm writing to tell you that I'm resigning. For the past 4 years, you've humiliated, belittled, and abused me, and I just can't take it anymore. Your former manservant, Paul. It's terribly shocking to me. I had no idea your name was Paul. Surely we must have had some good times together, too. I can't remember any specifically, but there must have been some. If only there was some sort of montage to remind me. Me. Good time. Why are you moving on? Did you get a better job? Have you met someone? Another man? Scandalous. A girl? That's a surprise. Someone's changed their tune. Your tune used to be more Broadway than rock and roll. Well, I hope she's very strict, because you're a very naughty boy, aren't you? Well, that's sad. Never mind. Get me another one, will you? Another manservant. What are you doing? Oh, yes, all right, then. Give me a hug. All right. Could you hug a little lower, would you? Goodbye and good luck. I'll never forget you, buddy. Sorry, was that me? Did I just bar there? Sometimes when I'm upset, I bar, apparently. Oh, well, I feel sad. I've lost my servant. I'll have a new one, though. I'll have a new sidekick next week. Join me then. Why don't you? Someone confident, someone decisive, someone not afraid to wear a big funny thing on his head. Perhaps it'll be Donald Trump. Ah-ha-ha! All right.
Growth hormone's gone haywire. I took the antidote and it seems to be working a little too well. I'm now officially Tom Cruise size. I know. Let me tell you something.
Welcome back, everybody. Hey, you look good. Did you moisturize during the commercials?
I creeped myself out too.
My first guest is on the CSI New York. It's a fantastic show. Wednesdays here on the CBS. Take a look at this.
Thank you.
just went to the bathroom a little bit. Please welcome Melina Kanakarides, everybody. Seen you in a long time. How long is it since you've been here?
It's been way too long, but I'm very excited that there was chemistry with Drew Carey because I'm also from Ohio. Cleveland was our big city. I'm a Cleveland girl, Akron girl, so.
Really? From
there Akron? Might be chemistry with
there
us.
There definitely
right?
is chemistry with okay, us. Good. I tell you now, I love Akron and I'll tell you why. Tires.
I know.
They made the tires for the entire auto industry for years.
They
Akron did.
Yes. They called it the rubber capital.
Thank you, Akron. Thank you, Akron, for the smooth ride. Yeah, no, I like Akron. It's a nice place. Lots of nice things come out of Akron.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh. What about the big CSI show? Are you still having
yes,
a nice time? Because Sinise is a cranky bastard, isn't he?
He's actually a sweetheart. No, did you like me hanging from that seven-story building?
Exciting.
And I was really doing that.
Really?
Yeah, there's a harness on me. Yeah. You couldn't see, they, you know, erased the thingies, the wires. But it was so cool. I actually sent, emailed a photo to my husband from the iPhone, and then the response quickly was, "Are you crazy? Yeah. No, we got two children!
Does
get
he
down.
Does he type, he's got a yeah, very big the, iPhone now?
No, he's got the little, yeah, I know.
Are you gadgety? Do you have?
I like. I'm a Mac girl. I love my. My parents just had their 50th wedding anniversary, and I did the whole iMovie and the book.
No, we have to be fair and balanced here. Mac and PC. I have to say,
my
husband's
a PC.
Stuff. Well, I like the Mac stuff, but I have to see these commercials where that groovy kid is picking on the PC guy. I'm like, piss off, you little rat! The PC guy's like trying to have his life, and they. I mean, and I like Mac stuff as well, and I'm thinking, knock that crap off. Drives me mad. I'm gonna, oh, I'm so trendy. Oh, are you? I'm gonna get a PC just to annoy you, you little. No, don't mind. Hey, how was your summer? What did you do?
I had an amazing summer. I met the Pope this summer.
What?
I did meet
the Pope. What, in a bar?
I did.
Where did you meet him?
No. I actually, our patriarch, the Greek Orthodox patriarch.
You're not
invited.
Catholic, you're Greek
we're Greek Orthodox.
Right, okay.
But it's basically the same. We're very, 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 very similar, very right. close. It was one church. It was called the Apostolic Church. If those of you who are go to church or religious, it's, I believe, one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. When the schism happened.
When did the schism happen?
The schism happened about 1,000 years ago.
What happened then? Why was there a schism?
I guess there was some translational problems. You know, there weren't Macs, the cell phones, or PCs. So people couldn't,
So the Greek Orthodox and the Catholic Church split off from each other.
We split off. It was one church. It was an apostolic church, and they split off, and they took the word Catholic, which is really a universal, meaning universal, because the apostles created Christianity from St. Paul, St. Peter. Quick lesson. So then they, Catholic
no, I need it. Tell me.
Anyway.
You might want to do a bit of saving while you're here as well.
Our archbishop was invited by our patriarch to bring some people together, and they invited me, which I was very honored, but I was told to bring my whole family. My girls included 5 and 8, two little girls, 5 and 8. So, I mean, 3 hours of church is a long time for anyone.
Yeah, no, tell me.
But we were holding our breath because we were at this is at the Vatican. It was just beautiful. The Patriarch and
I've
the Pope coming
to the
together.
It's very nice.
Oh, it was beautiful. And they said the creed in Greek, the original.
Do you speak Greek?
I do speak Greek.
So you knew what they were saying then?
Yes. Right. It was amazing. And my girls speak Greek.
Right.
And
5 years old, they speak Greek.
Well,
that's
they
clever.
Spoke Greek before they spoke English.
Oh, there's the trick.
And yeah. But of course, they hear Italian or Latin, and they just assume everything's Greek. So we were in church literally for 3 hours before meeting the Pope and the Patriarch in this little room.
Did you mention to the Pope that you weren't a Catholic, that you were Greek Orthodox?
He knew.
Oh, he
invited our Patriarch, who sat with him. And they're
the two together.
Yeah, they're two heads.
Oh, that's nice.
So it was just beautiful, and it was cool. But 5 minutes before we're going to meet the big Pope, the guy, the main guy.
It's not like, it's the regular sized Pope. There's only one Pope. It's not like you work your way up to the big Pope, little Pope, middle sized Pope, big Pope. There's one Pope, one Holy Father, that's who it is.
That's so true.
Yeah.
Well, for us, there's two, because, you know,
oh, well, of course, there's the patriarch. So yeah, yeah.
He's our pope. So
right.
I prepped the girls before we were going to meet, and I said to my little one and my big one, I'm like, so you guys remember, we're going to kiss the ring, you do your cross, when you're in church, you do this whole thing. I mean, I had it all drilled in. So Karina finally, my little one, looks at me, and she's like, okay, so tell me about these guys again. Are they, like, best friends with God or something? And I said, Yeah, basically.
No, listen, does the Pope watch the CSI show?
I don't think so.
Really?
I don't think that's on his agenda.
I don't know. I mean, I think there must come a point in someone, you know, even if you're like the head of a giant church, there must be a time when you think, you know, I'm just going to watch TV tonight.
I don't know. I mean, I did have a bishop in church taking a picture of me, and it was the most surreal, bizarre thing.
A TMZ bishop?
I know, he was...
Wow. How odd. That's fantastic. I mean, terrible. I mean,
no,
I'm not sure.
It was bizarre.
Listen, I wish we had more time. I'm fascinated about this. But we're out of time. Will you come back and talk more about this?
Yes, I would love to.
Interesting to me. Very interesting to me, in fact. Melina Kanakarides, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Let me just get this. You got a little hair on you there. Let me just get that. You know, I once did that to an actress. I said, you got a little hair on it. When I was working in a play, I said, you got a little hair. And I went to pull the hair and it went like that. I know. My next guest is a mixed martial artist. You know, the mixing the kung fu and the boxing and the haikaji and everything. The next fight is live on this network on Saturday night, 9 p.m. on CBS. Take a look at this. Please welcome the lovely Gina Carano, everybody. Are you all right?
Oh, I'm nervous.
I think it's so odd that you would be nervous to be in a talk show. I mean, what goes wrong? Kick my ass. It'd be fine.
Usually I get to, like, let out some aggression, you know, with this nerve, and so I might have to.
No, you must. Anyway, look, there's no glory in kicking my ass. You need to... It's like, you know, Richard Simmons could kick my ass, really. Do you remember that? There was a guy once sued Richard Simmons for hurting him in an airport or something. And I was like... Have you lost all semblance of manhood that you admit that Richard Simmons would hurt you in a... Anyway, that's
Wait,
just me.
Was that before my time a little bit then? Probably.
Was that? Well, yeah, it might be. Yeah. Have you been fighting for a long time?
No, just 4 or 5 years.
4 or 5 years?
Yeah.
Does it hurt?
Certain things, yeah, but I'd rather, you know, I'd rather get a black eye than have a miserable life, you know?
Yeah. They're not mutually exclusive, you know.
Meaning I'd rather, you know, have a job where I travel and
right.
fight people and train than be married with children who hate me and a horrible husband.
Was that the only option available to you? Because I'm sure you can have both. I think it'll be fine. Now, tell me a little bit about the martial arts, the mixed martial arts. What exactly do you use? Boxing?
Oh, boxing, jiu-jitsu, Muay Thai.
What's Muay Thai? Because I thought that was... You know.
Yeah, Muay Thai.
Muay Thai, that's
Muay Thai.
It.
Muay Thai is just like a hardcore form of kickboxing, so...
Right.
It just gets the job done. Everything you do hurts the other person. So if I kick you, it's going to hurt. If I, you know, elbow you, it hurts.
I don't know why. I'm kind of like, can I be honest? I find this kind of sexy.
That's good.
That's weird, isn't it? Because I mean, I'm not even German, and I'm like...
I'm glad some guys out there.
Yeah, you know. No, I mean, do you have trouble with men and dating and all that kind of thing?
Well, I can just see them thinking, you know, could she kick my ass? And I'm like, you know, I just want a guy to be comfortable and confident and, you know,
well,
if I can, all right, I might, but it's all right.
There's no kicking anybody's ass, even if you can in a relationship. It's a different set of rules.
What kind of relationships are you in? No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah. What is your favourite kind of, like, get the job done hold in the ring? Do you have a speciality, a hashigishi or something?
I think one of my fights, I ended in a rear naked choke.
A what choke?
You want me to show you?
No, I don't.
You put your hooks in on the person's legs right here.
Hooks?
Hooks, your feet.
Oh, your feet.
Yeah.
You have different words for feet?
And then you wrap your arm around them. And then kind of squeeze until they tap.
Is that what you do? You tap out or they pass out?
Yeah, they pass out or they pass out.
I kind of like that. I'm kind of like, what the hell is wrong with me? There's a whole part of me I never knew about. I'm like, wow, really? So, like, you could kill me? That's awesome. That's weird.
Have you ever been in a fight before?
Yeah, I've been in a lot of fights.
Yeah.
Never with anyone as attractive as yourself. Maybe that's where I was going wrong. Because it would be guys in bars. It wasn't proper fighting. It was.
That's where I started.
In bars? Really?
Well, I'm kind of a shy person, and so people mistake that. You know, they think it's, like, stuck up or whatever, when really some people just like to keep to themselves a little.
Where did you grow up? Where are you from?
Vegas.
Oh, Las Vegas, yeah. Oh, no, don't patronize her.
Jeez. How does that explain?
Yeah, it makes me crazy when you do that.
Yeah, I went to a small Trinity Christian high school in the middle of Vegas, across the street from a gay bar and a jeweler's and a, yeah, 5 minutes
I
away from
there. I know where you're talking about. I know that little place. Do you do a lot of fighting in Vegas?
I used to, but now we're traveling all over the place. The next one's in Florida. I've been to Thailand, you know.
It's a huge growth sport, this thing, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, everybody's crazy for it.
Fastest growing.
Why do you think that is?
I think it's because it's honest, it's real. It's kind of like you can't really hide, you know, anything in the cage. It's just real. You're, you know, two people going at it.
Yeah, it's...
It's kind of like sex. No, I'm just kidding.
Hey. Whatever way you get the job done, that's how you get the job done. It is delightful to meet you, young lady. You've done... Lovely Gina Carano, everybody. My next guest is a Scottish singer-songwriter. Yes. Where do all these people come from? Coming over here, taking our jobs. Go back to Scotland, Scottish people. She's here performing Mr. Rock and Roll from her debut album, This Is The Life. Please welcome the extraordinarily talented Amy MacDonald, everybody. Amy MacDonald.
Sees all that one could see. He's living proof of someone very different. before.
I learned on the show tonight, if I learned nothing else, like when I was talking to Gina, who's like a really, you know, she's attractive. And I'm kind of like, I'm confused. I don't know about myself anymore. I'm looking in the mirror thinking, who are you, strange fruit? what else did we learn on the show? We learned that Akron is the rubber capital of the United States. Probably many of you knew that, but it's never a bad thing to always just underline that Akron, you know, did a lot for this country. ha-ha-ha to you. What about riding around with no tires in your car? See how you ha-ha-ha then, you bastards. Sorry, Akron. We also learned that I never slept with David Spade. I did. No, I didn't. No, I didn't. Because I'd remember, I'm sure. And what else did we learn? I don't think we learned much else tonight. But then again, it's not really educational television, is it? I mean, if you're watching this show to learn stuff, you're way behind the curve in the learning. This is not really where you should be learning things. I'm still kind of troubled by how attractive Gina was to me. I think I have to do some investigations. But I don't know what that means. Stay tuned and I'll fill you in on my sexual curiosity. Good night, everybody. We'll be right back.